Thank you so much, sir, for an enlightening speech. I now take immense pleasure to invite Professor H. A. Ranganath, Director, National Assessment and Accreditation Council, Bangalore, to address this occasion.
Ellarigu namaskara. Highly respected His Excellency Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam and our esteemed guest of honor, Dr. Parameshwar, Dr. V.S. Acharya, Mr. Husni Aish, Mohammed Husni Karim, and the president of the nation, that is Majid A. Sabah, my dear students, faculty, and the invitees. Tradition is when once the excellency speaks, there is no provision for others to speak. We have just now heard the most illuminating. As Dr. Acharya said, I also heard so many convocation lectures. For the first time, I could admit that ground reality was there in his speech. And moral was there, message was there, and still the ideas are ringing in my mind. I only wish all of us work hard to make those moral suggestions, the messages, a reality in our career. And whatever he said, it's not only for students, it is for all of us. So at this juncture, I have no hesitation to congratulate the students here, because you are coming out of a very reputed institution for two reasons. One, I was the Vice Chancellor of Bangalore University with more than 800 colleges. I have no problem with college. I have a problem with other colleges. I had no problem with this particular college. It is smooth affair. Secondly, it has been accredited by National Assessment Accreditation Council. That means you are the graduates of an accredited institution. When once it is accredited, it means you had a quality education. Now, accreditation is an international currency, that wherever you go, this accreditation symbol, the brand name, will help you to get further positions or to improve your academic career. Therefore, on both the counts, you are extremely lucky to have gone through this exercise in this highly prestigious college. Now, I have seen many institutions and colleges always measure the quality of institution on three parameters. One is academic ambience. What is that academic ambience? It is the quality of the faculty and the other things related to the academics. And as I could see in the profile, we have an excellent galaxy of the faculty. That provides the academic ambience. The second ambience is the physical ambience, the infrastructure, the library, the computer application, etc., etc. That also is extraordinarily high. And the most important is the moral ambience. As I could see, the day on which I got the invitation from the president until today, I could see an aroma of discipline and moral values that are imprinted in this institution. Therefore, I'm sure the parent must be extremely happy to see that their children have got the best of the talent, best of the training in this institution. Therefore, I'm sure that these students who have graduated from this institution have a better future in the days to come. And now, we always speak of internationalization of education. Already it is happening. And today, as Mr. Sahib said, already we have the representations from 46 different countries. I must say, Bangalore is both an exporter of education and also an importer of education. One such thing has happened in this Brindavan College. Therefore, I have no hesitation to compliment this institution for becoming a part of this Bangalore University and the Visheshwara Technical University in bringing people across the world to show what Bangalore is, what India is. That's how internationalization of higher education is taking place. So without taking any much of the time, I only pray God to bless all my students here to fulfill the dreams of their parents. Because the parents have many dreams, so all of you have to work hard to fulfill the dreams of your parents and that of the institution. May God bless each one of you.